Hi, welcome to Mr. Otter Studio. Today I'm going to show you how to make a Notan cube just using paper, scissors, and glue. It's a really fun activity and it's a great way to learn about balance and also contrast and finding this balance between light and dark. Notan is the combination of lights and darks, and it's used a lot in Japanese art, and it really is a way to create balance if you think of the yin and the yang. That's kind of how the balance was created, you know, flipping the lights and the darks and mirroring them. And we're kind of creating our own sense of balance today with our own Notan artwork. And it's snowing outside and really dark here, so sorry it's a little bit dark. The supplies you need are white and black paper. You can use scissors or an X-Acto knife to cut out your shapes. If you are using an X-Acto knife, make sure you have something to cut on. This is just the back of one of my watercolor paper pads that I'm just gonna... I could cut on if I wanted to, but I think I'm just gonna use scissors. A glue stick to glue it down. The first step is to make your squares. So cut your square out of your white paper and your square out of your black paper, and make sure the black square is half of the size of the white square. And that's so when you cut out your design, as long as you don't go past the middle of your square, you can fit it all on your paper. And let's get started. So cut out your designs. You can cut out organic shapes, geometric shapes. It's totally up to you what you create. I've just been feeling a little bit like I want spring to be here, and so I've got plants on my mind. And make sure to keep track of those shapes, because the next part's almost a game where we try to figure out where on earth they go. We want to keep the black paper together. So whatever you cut out, try to make sure that you keep that black, main black square together, and you're just cutting pieces out of it. This is like drawing with scissors is really, really fun. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. You can do more than this. I just wanna show you how you would finish it. I just like to start by gluing this main piece down, and maybe, I feel like this is too symmetrical. I'm gonna add one more thing coming out of this corner. So glue your square down that you've cut your shapes out of. You can kind of choose which side you want to be the top and which side you want to be the bottom, and try to get it so it's centered. You could use your ruler. Step number three is to arrange these outside shapes so that they mirror these inside shapes. So this isn't a mirror. This is actually kind of the opposite, which I think looks really cool. You could do that. You don't have to do anything that I say. I think that it looks cool doing it the opposite way, but I'm going to do it. I'm just going to mirror it just so you can see what that would look like, but you can do it however you would like. So first I just kind of like to make sure my pieces are ready, because I don't want to glue anything down before I make sure I've got these pieces in the right places. So you're just trying to find that mirror image, and then once it is how you like it, and you could change it. I mean, you could break these pieces off and make, I don't know, make a little chaos. All right, then you want to take your glue and glue those shapes down. And remember, we're trying to create harmony here. So if it would feel more balanced if you changed some things, then you should. Oh, and this one is the wrong direction, but it just feels right. I don't know, if it's going this way, I want it to be going the same direction as this one. So I'm switching that one. So feel free to take a little liberty with this project. And that's it. So it's called the Notan Square, the Notan Cube, but it's a pretty simple project, and I think it's an effective way to understand the power of contrast, the power of balance, and the power of light and dark. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today. Have fun making your projects. I would love to see them. If you put them on Instagram, just use the hashtag Mr. Otter Studio, and I usually scroll through those once a week to see what you're creating. And I hope you have a wonderful day.